anything else we would ask us for today? Okay. She will read for us.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I am reading from 1 Peter chapter 4, verses 12 through 19. Beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened to you. But rejoice, inasmuch as you are partakers of Christ's suffering, that when his glory shall be revealed, you may be glad with exceeding joy. If you be reproached for the name of Christ, happy are ye, for the Spirit of glory and of God resteth upon thee. On their part he is evil spoken of, but on your part he is glorified. But let none of you suffer as a murderer, or as a thief, or as an evildoer, or as a busybody in other men's matters. Yet if any man suffers as a Christian, let him not be ashamed, but let him glorify God on his behalf. For the time has come that judgment must begin at the house of God, and it first begins at us. What shall the end of them be that obey not the gospel of God? And if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear? Wherefore, let them that suffer according to the will of God commit the keeping of their souls to him in well-doing, as unto a faithful Creator.
Amen.
Power in the Blood, if you want to use your hymnal. It's on page 159. We're going to sing the first and last verses.
Thank you.
time, so I'll give you a few moments of those things. Again, maybe special to you about this, as you pray. Remember again, this is getting close to the end of the year, the fiscal year, and a lot of things happen that need to be aware of, not just in church, but there are some loads, but also things politically, socially. Just keep your ears open, and if you see those things that may need to, in your mind, to be prayed for, just look. Don't have to be in place special, don't have to do anything special, just pray to the Lord. Let's pray. Father, it's always a joy that we get up to you to come to your house. Well, it's been a beautiful day you've given to us. It's wonderful, Father, just to be able to experience the beauty of your creation. Realize afresh in you how wonderful you are, how strong and mighty you are. And also, Lord, as we thank you for opportunity to pray, we thank you how merciful you are, how gracious and loving. Opportunity we have, Father, to bring before these on our prayer list, especially these we mentioned today. But all those, Father, that have spoken or unspoken, we know that there's so many that need to know that you care and concern. Most of all, Father, that you're doing what's necessary in your life to intervene on some behalf, bring some source of comfort, consolation. Thank you, Father, for the fact that we can always testify to the fact that you've been good to us. You've answered our prayers. You've been there when we needed you. We do pray for those that know it's our duty responsibility that each day, Lord, lived up. So many that we believe, Lord, that it's our Christian responsibility because you love us and, Lord, because you instill in us a compassion for those who need our prayers and our efforts. We pray for those that just hurting, Father, for whatever reason. Those who, maybe day by day, looking for something to get them through that day, a time, Father, just to reflect on a few moments before they have to go on their way again, a way that may not be very pleasing to them, a way, Father, maybe very painful in some way. So, pray, Father, just a moment of refreshing in their lives and know that you're there and you're available and you're always going to be your source, their source and their guide, their strength in those times. For those, Father, that we know that you put in place the power. We don't understand sometimes how it happens. Why, Father, we believe you're the source of all power. So when it happens, Lord, we ask you, Lord, to be with them. Give them clear minds and heads and opportunity, Father, to seek your guidance and direction. For those, Lord, all around our world that struggle simply because of misuse of the power, we pray you just be with them that know there's a day coming when all those will be judged for their misuse, Father, of what you've given to them. Lord, we just sometimes can't find the right words to just thank you for what you're doing for us, how you continue to bless us day by day in spite of all that we see around us. In spite of all that we believe is going wrong in our world, Father, you're still the one that's always right, always true, always responsible. So bless our day. Well, it's the time we celebrate our Lord's Supper. We are reminded again of what you did for us through Christ, his offering of yourself for us, our sins. Lord, that as we have opportunity day by day, may our lives express the joy that we have because you live in us. Forgive us for our faults and failures. Thank you once again that you give us opportunity day by day to confess our sins and to be cleansed, renewed, and revived. Bless our day and glorify him. We ask in Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
This morning we're going to sing Behold Him, so y'all stand. And join us as we sing another song of praise to Him, just behold Him of His glory and His honor and who He is.
He who was before there was light, walked across the pages of time, He who made every living thing, behold Him. He who heard humanity's cry, left His throne to wake as a child, He became like the least of us, behold Him. Jesus, Son of God, Messiah, the Lamb, the roaring Lion. Oh, be still and behold Him.
Thank you.
about you all, but I started a little slow this morning, but I'm about up speed now.
Amen.
What I want to do, and it's going to be up to you all. I like to do this, and obviously y'all don't like to do it near as much as I do, but I would like to take time to have some testimonies. We've been through a lot since we did this last. We've been through an election, been through a pandemic, been through a lot of things that's happened to quite a few of our folks here lately. So it's a time that God's done something good, special for you, and I want to hear you say so. And that would be the, I want to read one verse from the Psalm 107. And if you do good, you won't hear the rest of it. But actually, verses 1 and 2. Psalms 107, verses 1 and 2. Give thanks to the Lord. He's good. His faithful love endures forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord proclaim that he's redeemed them from the hand of the foe. King James says, let the redeemed say so. So I want you to say so this morning.
I just praised the Lord a year ago today. If y'all remember, I was struggling. I'd been to the emergency once already. Took 3 trips to the emergency room. They finally admitted me, treated me for the COVID. And everybody that come in, I told them, y'all got to get me well. I said, my son's being ordained as a deacon. And my daughter's getting married. I said, y'all have got to get me well. I said, God is working through y'all to heal me.
Amen.
So I just give him all the praise and the glory. I got to see it all.
Amen. Which one was most important?
That I got to see it all.
Mom, go.
That you should have to live for God. And
steeped in the Bible of your morals and your character. And we as adults should live that life before them that will lead them in the way that we want them to go.
Mm-hmm.
And I already have a special request on the prayer list, but today I really do have a very special request. If you go with me and watch over me and care for me until my time comes.
Amen.
And I can say I'm ready for it, but I hate to leave a lot of people. But if it's His will, it will be done.
Amen.
For me, lots of things have happened in the last year. Way too many things have happened in the last year. From having COVID to losing my dad to, you know, taking care of Sherry on a bigger basis than we had before. And then, you know, having him throw some other things our way, curveballs. But through it, God's perfect timing is perfect. There were so many things that have happened to us in the last year that you didn't understand why it was happening or why it took so long for something to happen. But then, in hindsight, we go, oh, that's a good thing that this happened because that was God's time and He knew ahead of time what was going to happen before we knew. And for me, my favorite verse has been Philippians 4:13. It says, I can do everything through Christ who strengthens me. And there's sometimes you think, oh, how am I going to get through this? Or how am I? He gives you the strength to do it.
Amen.
You can accept it with something good, which we always like to do. And we can also do the things that are hard for us to do because He's already been there. He's done that.
Mm-hmm.
And He gives us the strength to keep us going. I'm just very thankful for that.
Amen. You mentioned that 4:13. I was going to do my old Christmas decoration, which was going down, and I ran across this CD that I think it was in Mary's Vacation Bible School class. It was one lady had done, and that's been several years ago. And he had on there his favorite Bible verse, which was Philippians 4:13, that He can do all things through the strength of God. I was throwing things away. I thought, there's no way I'd throw that away.
I guess I've been a spectator because really and truly I have been blessed with my health and everything else this past year and a half. No, I haven't been happy about some things that I've seen happen. I have lost many, many people that I've known, you know, like through my nursing career, through my extended friends and things like this. But I also saw miracles. And like Sheila was saying, God has a time for all of it. So I'm hoping that I have presented myself because I do pray very, very religiously. I don't know if that's a good way to put it or not. And I just hope that I have been a good prayer warrior through all of this. That's my prayer, is that I have shown that I was a prayer warrior. I've tried to check on people. Y'all would not believe the extension of people I have checked on. I try to keep up with people. I try to figure out what to do. But I've been very blessed. So am I a spectator? I guess so. But then again, all this has affected me also. And the fact that, no, I haven't always been happy with some of the inner adults, but God has a time. And I have been very blessed.
God does things on God's time. We always say God's time. God has no time.
Well,
that's right. When he does in our time, in our time, we all, you know, it works out for us. And because his understanding is much greater than ours. He does see beyond the horizon. He sees over the hill. He sees around the curve. And fits our time. And thankfully, He works in our time. Thankfully, he pays heed to our time. Something to be thankful for and rejoicing. Yeah. All right, come on.
Guys, well, this time last year, y'all didn't see me very much because I was going through a really heavy dose of first zero iron, but then it became more of depression, anxiety. But through several members of this church, they reached out to me, prayed for me, gave me direction. I get out. I go places now. Depression is way on the bottom of the scale.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Lots of iron infusions. My iron is up. It's just, God's blessed me very well with great friends, great prayer warriors, and my family, because I don't have much family. God's just really blessed me with just seeing what he can do that I thought was kind of impossible.
He does impossible.
Yes, he does.
Until this last year, I've been kind of down and out and all this kind of stuff because I never wanted to retire. It was forced on me. But I've started working with the caring center. And I think God has made me find new purpose. I'm just a changed person.
Amen.
Especially when I go down there. When I get to work, I still don't know all the ladies' names, you know, but every time I go down, Karen! They get to lift stuff. It's just something else. I mean, it's a Christian organization. All these ladies are from different churches, you know. And Terry goes down there also, but I mean, she got me to going down there. And God has just lifted me. God has blessed me in things. I don't want for nothing. I pray, I talk to God, put him first, and things happen. I mean, I feel good. Lost a little weight.
Speaking of volunteering, I would like to put a prayer request in. I've got another group that I did a fourth class. I went ahead at 3 weeks post my knee replacement. I was teaching again at the Women's Center. And tomorrow night is the baby shower. We brought in one to deliver her twins. And she was almost term, y'all. It was amazing. But tomorrow night, just remember these three young ladies that has not delivered yet, and just keep everyone in prayer that, you know, is praying and things like that. But I was blessed in the fact that when I went 3 weeks, I was horrible, I was in pain. I sat there and got through it, and then gradually they have seen me over 4 weeks get better, from 3 weeks to almost 7 now. But, you know, like I said, just keep them in your prayer. And tomorrow night we are having the baby shower at Garden of First Baptist, so, you know, just be in prayer for these young ladies.
Yeah, I know. That's a good organization, quick.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
And Terry, the name of those women you can't think of?
Sue.
Yes, ma'am.
Cindy. It's
always, it's yes, ma'am. Just like the ladies here. Yes, ma'am.
Gayla.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Those are
great.
He knows me when I walk. I wasn't
here today. Anyone else? Now, come on. Doing pretty good.
To say that the past year was a roller coaster is to put it mildly. I think all of us could say a year and a half we never saw coming what was coming, but we know that God did.
Yes, ma'am.
And my attitude has not been great at times as I struggled through what our church has been through. What our country's going through, what my kids at school are going through. But like I said, God knew this was coming, and we're designed for this time. So he has got plans for us. And so my prayers have turned in this through this time is to for us to get out of this season what we're supposed to.
Amen.
Because most of the things are not what we would have chosen at all.
Amen.
And it's hard. It's been very hard. But like Sheila said, God is our strength. He gives us the strength that we need to get through it. And you look at folks in the Bible and the awful things that they endured and how they grew through it and what legacies they left behind. And that's what we need to strive for, is to live the life that God wants us to, learn from the trials and learn through these tough times, come out better on the other side than we were when we started.
Yeah.
And just remember that we are not called to live a life of comfort and a life of ease. We are not called to live a life that's about what I want or what my plans are, because His are greater and His are better. And that maybe that's one of the things I've learned so far through what we've experienced. And so God has been faithful when my attitude has been horrible, when I've had moments where I just want to throw my hands up and just quit. That's not who we are. It's not what we're supposed to do. That's the easy way out. And we're not called to do the easy life.
Amen. God does not dictate all that we go through. God can carry us through all we go through.
Right.
He'll just do.
Amen.
Oh. Y'all know me and my emotions. I can't talk. Oh. But God is great. God is great. We've got problems ahead that we have never seen before. And we have got to get together and get through this. All the Christians got to pull together, because we're losing our country. You've got to be informed. But God is great.
Yes, yes, yes.
And that's one thing also I think through this is we tend to want to lean on our own strength and think that we can fix things. And that's a wake-up call in this also, is just really truly let us know how dependent we are on Him. And He works through people, but we've got to depend on Him.
He's our source. Anyone else there?
I kind of feel guilty that I haven't really been through a lot with all this, except for watching others and praying for others.
Well, that's the job of all of us, if we have opportunity, just to look and notice and pray.
Okay.
we always see occasionally someone posts a picture that just saw someone going through something awful, terrible, and down at the bottom said, "Lord, if I ever complain, let me see this again."
Exactly.
There's always someone, regardless of how bad we're at, shape we're in, there's always someone that does worse. And all we can hope then is that they have the same God we do, help us get through it. Let me share, we read our verses, because I think that's what we need to do today. One of the things we'll turn things around is that we just say so regarding what God means to us and what God offers to all of us. And we'll read those verses again from the Message paraphrase. I think it did a wonderful job. It says, "Oh, thank God, He's so good. His love never runs out." That'd be a for a song, but all of you set free by God, tell the world, tell how He freed you from oppression. Let the redeemed, you know who the redeemed are?
Us.
That's us. Let the redeemed say so, or let the redeemed declare all the good things that we know have experienced about God. I do believe with all my heart that many of the problems we're facing today, regardless of the area which they come from, politics, social, whatever, stems from the fact we are, as a church, are not doing what we as a church.
That's right.
Amen.
Right.
I'm talking about the whole church, not there, but I'm talking about the whole church. We are not being the salt and the light that we're supposed to be.
Yeah.
And we need to start just by saying, let the redeemed say so. Let us say something. Take our stand, what God said. It is the day of the Lord's Supper, so I'm going to ask you, always have a few moments of examination. Paul said, be able to look inside, make sure that we come do this. But this is a very solemn time when we think about what happened that immediately following that first supper, when Christ went to the cross and died for us, that's what the elements represent. But it's also a time of joy as we come to celebrate what those elements mean to us today.
Right.
So let's stand for a few moments and bow our heads and just give the Holy Spirit a moment to look inside. Maybe something needs to be confessed, move out of the way before we dissipate. Once again, heads bowed and eyes closed. Let's take a few moments and commune with the Lord. Thank you again that you announce these times. We can stop and you can tell us in your word. We just confess our sins. You're faithful and just to forgive us. So we just pray now that just become and become and forgiven. Cleanse, Father, by what you told us to do, Father, because of your promise to us. May we rejoice in our ceremony and may you receive the glory from it. We ask in Christ's name. Amen. I need a couple of deacons to handle these wonderful little things we're going to use here. You, the little top layer, you bend them down to start with, take a little top layer, a little film on top, has your little wafer, then the second one, you pull off, has the juice. So when the hour was come, he sat down, the apostles with him. He said unto them, I desire to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. If I say unto you, I shall not eat of it until it be fulfilled in the kingdom of God. He received a cup, and he had given thanks. He said, to take this and divide it among yourselves. For I say unto you, I shall not drink from henceforth the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God shall come. He took bread, and he had given thanks. He broke it, and gave to them, saying, this is my body, which is given for you, and this do in remembrance of me. The cup in like manner, after supper, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood, even that which is poured out for you. But behold, the hand of him that betrays me is with me on the table. For the Son of Man indeed goes as it has been determined, the void of the man to whom he is betrayed. We now come to observe the ordinance of the Lord's Supper, given to us to celebrate in memory of his broken body and shed blood. It is said that on the night before he was betrayed, at the conclusion of the feast of the Passover, which he and his disciples were celebrating, he took bread, having blessed it, broke it, gave to his disciples, and said, this is my body, which is given for you. Terry, would you make some prayer?
Father, we've come to you. We thank you, Father, for what the Lord's Supper means to us, Father. Father, we thank you for letting us share. And Father, we praise you and thank you for all your many blessings, Father. We know we're not worthy. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. We'll pass these out. And remember that we have just one time through, so get one.
Thank you.
And these are not the easiest of times.
Anybody else got theirs?
It's not the purple. Last time it was that purple one. You see that film a little bit better.
I think I got a mirror one.
Is everybody ready? I'm not, is everybody ready?
What is this? Lord's Supper 101?
Hey.
Are we on video?
This is the bread which came down out of heaven. Now as the Father's ate and died. He eats this bread, shall live forever.
Praise the Lord.
Right. On that same night, the Lord took the cup, having blessed it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "This is my blood, which was shed for you." David, do this.
Father God, we just thank you so much for this day and just all the blessings you've given us, and just the hard times you've brought us through, and just where you brought us and what you're doing with us, Lord. We just thank you so much for this Lord's Supper and the sacrifice that it represents. We just pray that we would live each day with that in the front of our minds and just share that love with others. We thank you and praise you for it all. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And now, the next little thing.
Anybody need help on the juice, the wine?
But it didn't pull on the tab. I had to get open from the side.
Well, I found
it. Open mine from the tab. Here,
I got it.
Okay.
Appreciate it.
Sure. I'm almost there.
Your hands are too big. That's the problem.
According to the law, a man will slay all things or cleanse with blood. Apart from shedding of blood, there is no remission. But if we walk in the light, as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another, and the blood of Jesus, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. As often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death till he comes. And now, it's said after this that they sang a hymn, so we're going to do that after we do a... is there anything else we need to do before we dismiss?
Absolutely. At the associational meeting Monday night, the UAB campus minister asked us to say a prayer today around, I don't know if you call it supper or dinner, but whichever time it is. He and his wife are hosting six students from India for dinner tonight at their house. And he's been telling us, you know, how God is working at UAB. But just be in prayer that, you know, they'll be receptive and can form some relationships that will live in time.
Amen.
And I had one, a lady came a while ago seeking some help. Last name was Dillard, Miss Dillard. Said she just lost her husband and just lives down the road. Remember her, but I'm not sure all her needs there, but refer to the caring center. It's we understand, if you go to the caring center and need for food, you get food.
Right.
And of course they provide other things also, but primarily food, so remember that. As we refer most of the folks who come outside of church down to them, because they're more able to take care of, make sure that the needs are what they're supposed to be and everything.
Amen.
We have been hoodooed before in the past, and
right.
You know, we'll do that again. But if people need help, you know, do what we can. And the Caring Center is wonderful at doing that, helping us do something.
It's amazing what they do.
Yes.
I mean, we know food work.
Oh, yeah.
People don't understand.
I mean, they've also got clothes down there. I mean,
It's a wonderful extension of the Christian art, the church art.
Right. Well,
that you said.
Oh,
anything else before we dismiss?
We have a 1-8 meeting at 4:30 today.
And small groups of five, and then of course 10-5. We do have a little time here. We pray for the church, and we need prayers, all our churches. I mentioned this earlier. Let me do it one more time, so maybe you can help me remember. We will try to get something started where at least once a week or something we remember the other church in our association. We have 37, 38 churches, and several of them are struggling, but it would be nice, because occasionally we get a letter or a postcard that says that they pray for us. It would be nice to let them know we do also remember those other churches that we work with, associate with. So help me remember that, and we'll get something fixed up.
Give me a list of them, and I'll go schedule for us.
All right. That'll be good. And I think we need to pray for each other individually, but also churches pray for each other.
We have got to pull together.
We in this together.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Same thing.
Other stand? Anything else? We remember all the great things God has done.
We believe that greater things are still to come.
We're going to sing Blessed Be the Tie.